I specifically opted for a trim level on this card that did not include a built-in display, so that later I could go back and add my own display. And up until today, it's had some extra on-screen gauge clusters or a Kodi media center. But lately, I saw a bunch of YouTube videos showing how you could run Android Auto on a Raspberry Pi, so that's what we're taking a look at today. And good news for everyone, this is one of those Raspberry Pi projects where the developers actually took the average user into consideration, so it's incredibly easy to set up. First question though, why bother? Because Android Auto really doesn't add that much more functionality than you would already get on your phone. But what it does do is help to make things more legal. You see, depending on which one of the 50 states you're in, you cannot have a hand holding your phone so that you can see a map of where you're going. But if you replace that busy hand to hold a soda or a burger, and the phone is in the same place, just hooked up to a vent instead of your hand, then it would be totally fine. America. Besides making looking at a map legal on the road once again, the other reason I'm doing this is because I never check traffic before I set out on a journey, and for someone who drives 20,000 miles a year, I should probably do that more often than I do. But even if I'm just making the 5-mile trek to go visit my sister, I never check traffic, and I end up about once or twice a month getting stuck in a 30-minute to a 1-hour slowdown on the highway. And it sure would be nice if this would save me a couple hours a month. That real-time traffic package will cost you thousands at the dealership, or about $100 for a Raspberry Pi touchscreen cables and micro SD card. To get this set up, all you have to do is attach the touchscreen to your Raspberry Pi, download the operating system, link in the description. If you don't already have a way to flash the OS onto a micro SD card, I highly recommend Belena Etcher, so download that too. Pop the micro SD card into the Pi, turn it on, and go through the setup process. Because this is Texas, I went with a metal case and fans and 3D printed a way to attach everything to the dashboard. PLA does not stand a chance in a hot car, so if you do want to download my free design and print one yourself, use ABS or even better, PETG. A couple years ago when I first ran Android Auto on my brother's car, I don't remember exactly which apps worked and which ones didn't, but I do know that today, at least, you have a choice between Google Maps and Waze, the two GPS map programs that I have on my phone, and I can even use programs such as Black Player to play the music as well, so I don't have to use just Google Music. So it's nice to know that you have a few options. Speaking of options, there's more videos to watch, like and subscribe buttons to click, why not both? Comments to leave, and I'll even accept donations in Doge or Bitcoin. Links for everything are in the description. See you in the next one.